Hi, everybody. It's Carla Nicole. Hope everybody is having a fantastic evening. This evening I want to talk about something that I think is vitally important that we talk about and discuss. As far as for me, I'm big about encouraging gentlemen about the importance of their erectile restoration. A lot of people, not just men, but women, constantly hear about ED, erectile dysfunction, gentlemen struggling with his rise to the occasion of sexual enjoyment. And let me just tell you, being a wisdom coach and having various clients that are struggling with this, especially the erectile dysfunction, it is a very, very discouraging and very, very trying experience for a man to go through. So I don't want to make light or jokes about it. This is something that is very real, okay? Men struggle with this at any age. Let's just clear that up too, because this is not about, well, when I get older or as an elder, I automatically am going to suffer from having erectile dysfunction. That's not true. But I want to talk about the gentlemen that are or have had this issue. And I first want to be very, very sensitive to the fact that I understand, because I have clients that talk to me in private about the struggle itself of having the erectile dysfunction. So first of all, I want to talk about that, number one. So erectile dysfunction is, and I try to keep everything as PG as possible. You know, we're talking about something that is a sexual issue, but I try to make it to be, you know, okay for everybody, because some people can't handle just the actual words. So I try to make it as, enjoyable to audibly say it so people can understand it. So for gentlemen to rise to the occasion, and they are not, it's very, very frustrating for the man to go through this. And I want to tell you first that most of my clients that have suffered from this struggle, number one, most of the time in silence. He does not talk, absolutely, Angela, anytime. He does not want to talk about this because there's so many pressures in our society about how the man's performance sexually is, a man's size, a man's longevity sexually, a man's, confidence, if you will, sexually. So all of these things are always cultivated in the man's mind of, oh my God, I have to perform, right? So when that man is not physically rising to the occasion, if you will, he has a, number one, a guilt, a shame, an embarrassment. And then on top of that, he has an issue with sitting back and saying, let me just allow myself to not get anxiety. Because understand something, when you're talking about erectile dysfunction, what is happening is there's not a blood flow to the penis to rise for the occasion. So the more a man is anxiety or flustered or getting all in a frenzy over it, it's causing the gentleman to not rise at all. So now he's thinking, oh my God, I have a problem, or oh my God, is there something wrong with me? And let me just put that out here. It happens, okay? We are all human. There's no one on the planet perfect. So gentlemen, you 9 times out of 10 are putting more pressure on you than your lady is. you know, and most women, I haven't had a lot of gentlemen say to me that most of their partners are not sensitive to it, or, you know, just downing him for it. I don't have too many of those issues. But what I do have is that the men are usually taunting themselves about this. They're taunting themselves about their performance, the fact that they're not rising, the fact that, you know, I don't know what to do. You know, is something wrong with me? You know, when I was young, I could get it up, or, you know, all kinds of things, you know? And so I want to talk about this because I think it's vitally important that, gentlemen, you understand that this can happen in any time or any stage of your life. Okay. So let's not get it confused that because of the fact that we're talking about erectile restoration, that that means that, you know, you're doomed. Some gentlemen believe that because they're not rising today, or haven't rised for a week, or haven't rised for a month, that they are doomed, and that's not the case. So I want to talk about why erectile restoration 9 times out of 10 improves the gentleman's confidence sexually. So a lot of times women are like, you know, I've been with my man for so long and he's always trying to hop on me, or he's pinching my butt, or he's wanting something. He's always asking for sex all the time. Then all of a sudden she don't hear nothing. Now it's like, well, what's going on? And then she's starting to initiate and nothing's going on. And she's like, well, what's going on? And now he doesn't want to say, look, I'm having some rise issues. You know, my equipment's not wanting to rise up for me. Even during masturbation. I know that's a scary word, but even during me self-pleasing, I'm not rising like I want to, or I'm not lasting as long. You know, and I mean, my clients come to me for different reasons. I mean, this is not always about the fact that the man is not being able to perform at all. Sometimes it's that they're performing fine. They just feel like they're not lasting long enough. So then I'm like, okay. Well, you know, let's come up with a plan on how to restore this. How do we, Angela, you're so funny. How do we restore this? How do we get it back for you to rise up and be able to last? Okay. So again, let's talk about what it is that helps the gentleman to rise. What helps the gentleman to rise is blood flow. Number one, blood flow. Blood flow, which is circulatory system. The circulatory system, okay? Do you guys realize? See, we take for granted, ladies, we take for granted that our men are rising up, but we don't realize that it is a process. A 4-stage process for a man to get from down to rise. It takes a 4-stage process. So we have to be mindful that, hold on a minute. How do I allow myself to be what? Patient. A lot of times gentlemen are frustrated because they're like, man, I want to perform. I want to do the best I can for my lady or whatever. And that's fine. But check dig though. Sometimes the body, the human body, has its own agenda, whether we want that agenda to be what we want it to be or not. So we have to be patient. We have to make sure that our partner that we're with is clear and understands that, hey, I'm just not rising like I used to. Now, understand, I understand, because a lot of my clients will come to me and they just, it's like they're a helium balloon. And so when they get to me, it's like I just take a little pin and they just, whew, I'm so glad I could tell you what's going on. I've been holding this in so long and it's been a trying time for me and I've been struggling with this and I think something's wrong with me. I had a gentleman all the way from India. Yes, India. He reached out to me saying, man, something's wrong with me. I said, what do you mean? You know, it's not working. And I told him, I said, well, sometimes it's not that it's not working. Sometimes it's mental. It's not what's between the legs, but what's between the ears here. And then you have to express your fears. We have to understand fear and anxiety are the two causes for erectile dysfunction. Believe it or not. Trust me, I've done some homework. I study sexual education all the time. I have been doing it since 17. Nothing new. So when I'm conveying things to you, trust me, I've done my homework. So with that said, understand that the erectile health comes from the circulatory system. How is your blood circulating through your body? Okay. So what I expressed to the gentleman in India that was struggling with not rising to the occasion, I told him, I said, listen, I said, first of all, you need to relax. What's going on with you in the mind? Not necessarily in the bedroom. I've been with my lady for a long time. Okay, so it's not the lady you're with then. This is something going on inside you. Well, you know, it's not moving like it used to. Well, you're aging. There's things that go on besides, you know, it's not always going to function according to how it used to when you were young. You know, you didn't even have to, it wasn't even a second thought. It was just always rising, even if it's occasions or not. So, you know, you have to understand that as we grow older and mature, things in our bodies change. We as women really go through changes, and they even call it the change for us. But gentlemen, you also have, you know, changes that you will transpire in the different stages of your life. Excuse me. So I wanted to put you guys up on game. See, it's very important that we understand that erectile restoration and improvement actually helps build that man's confidence back. He can throw his shoulders back. He can start getting more confident with his lady, getting back to the old him. But when a man feels like, I'm not able to perform, I'm not able to give it to my lady, he feels what? Broken, upset, embarrassed, shamed. Next thing you know, he's like this. But when that man gets it back, he's like, wow, here I am. I'm ready. So, you know, it's important that we don't mess around and we don't shun gentlemen, but we express to you that it's not abnormal. Okay, so I want y'all to get this because this is very important. You gentlemen have to understand that in order to restore the penile function and the erections to be more frequent, it's very important your diet. Dietary is huge. What are you putting in your mouth? What are you eating? Because you want to make sure that you're, number one, staying hydrated. Hydration is extremely important. So that means drinking a lot of water, drinking a lot of fluids that are clear fluids that are actually replenishing the semen. The testicular health helps to what? Rejuvenate the semen so that it can help you to rise. But of course, you have to have a good circulatory system going on. And if you're not doing the circulation properly, which means you're not exercising, you're staying just sleep way too long, your rest period, or you're not resting enough, you're working too much. See, a lot of gentlemen lose sight of the fact that your rest is vitally important to your restoration of your erectile health. Gentlemen, some of y'all are working 2-3 jobs to have a $250,000 house. But yet you're tired, you're exhausted, you're not getting enough rest. And then you have a woman that you're in a relationship with who's demanding you to have sex with her. And you just can't do it all because you don't have what? You don't have the rest. And men, when you are having your volcanic eruption or your explosions, if you will, you need some recover time to restore that. nine times out of 10, gentlemen, correct me if I'm wrong, okay? But nine times out of 10, gentlemen, once you have your volcanic eruption, you rest, right? You sleep. Am I right? Come on, gentlemen, tell me. If I'm wrong, tell me. Normally, at least in my experience with my exes, hey, y'all are out. It's like, you here? you here or what? So most of the time, gentlemen, you are resting. You're tired. Hey, Tony. You're tired and you're exhausted after you have your volcanic eruption. So once you have that volcanic eruption, that's a beautiful thing. But understand, though, you have to have a time of restoration of the semen. And in order to do that, you have to rest well. You have to have a good night's rest. Or if not a whole night, at least get you a good night nap rest in, right? So you can restore that. Very important. You also have to be mindful that when you are having sexual relations with your lady, I tell the gentlemen that come to my video show every month called Sensually Speaking, they know about this. So Shadrick, y'all the gents that come to my thing every month, they know. Y'all know about this. But the newbies has never come to my show, never came to Sensually Speaking, never been a part of my group. Y'all don't know about this, but I have created a technique called the rise and fall technique. And the rise and fall technique is a technique that is very good to help to restore erectile functioning. And what is the rise and fall technique? Well, the rise and fall technique is very, very, very simple. Basically, if you're really not rising to the occasion, or you don't feel that you're lasting as long, or you feel like your volcanic eruptions aren't as intense. So when you're having them, it's just like, they're okay, but they're just not like they used to be. Then I call it the rise and fall technique. So what does that mean? That means that you are rising, okay, with your lady, either performing, you're either doing it alone, which is self-pleasing, or your lady is touching you, or your lady is performing oral sex on you, or you're doing some type of foreplay, and you're finding yourself to rise, right? The initial rise is always great, and yes, it's great and all that, but it's vitally important that not only are you rising, but then you allow it to fall back down. Because this is going to help to intensify your volcanic eruptions. Because it's not going to just be all about the first time. It's going to allow you to build your stamina, help you build your erectile functioning. And see, a lot of times we just have intimacy and we just perform based upon, I don't know, movies or girlfriends telling us stuff, or guys, y'all talk to y'all boys about how it works. But I'm giving y'all some techniques that can help you to not only function better, but have explosions, have multiple explosions, which, yes, men, you are capable of having. I know it's not heard of, but you are. And so the rise and fall technique that I'm talking about, you can do it and perform this and find yourself having more intense, more gratifying sexual experiences. See, there's nobody out here teaching us this stuff. We learned about, you know, sex and health class, and they showed us how to put a condom on. They told us about all kind of STDs to be afraid about. But we really didn't talk about what kind of things we can learn to improve sex health. What can we do to get men's confidence back in their bedroom? Because you know what? Being a wisdom coach, I got a lot of people I talk to in the inbox, calling me on my 800 number, asking me, hey, listen, you know, I'm struggling because my husband isn't getting it up no more. I'm wondering if it's me. No, you guys aren't touching enough. And gentlemen, understand this. This is vitally important. And see, this kind of stuff I talk about every month anyway. So my vets know about this stuff. But Let me tell you something. Touch starvation is real in most relationships. Just telling you. So if your lady isn't caressing just your arm, the back of your knee, your thighs, your legs, and your toes and all that, if you're not being touched except in the penile area, then you're only, after a while, you can desensitize. And then it's not going to be as, I don't know, alluring as it would be if she begins to touch other parts of your body to get more engaged with you having a newfound area of sensitivity you didn't know. So like I say before, sometimes some of my gentlemen that I have that I talk to that are going through this issue, I tell them, stop focusing on the actual act itself. Stop focusing on rising. Just be in the moment and appreciate the touching sensation. Get out of your mind. Get out of your head. Stop focusing merely on, am I going to get an erection? Am I going to be able to perform? Because all of that is anxiety you're putting on yourself. You got to stop all of that. You got to sit back and say, okay, I'm willing to just allow. I'm just going to be here. And you will find when your woman touches you and caresses and moves you and you do more intimacy, more kissing, more holding, more just being embraced in the moment. When you have those moments, you'll find like, man, I'm moved now. Because remember, I told you earlier, it's about the blood flow, right? So the blood flow is what's going to get you the rise you need to keep you moving and to keep you engaged. And so I'm just telling you, I have a lot of gentlemen that feel uncomfortable about talking about this because it's not something that is, I don't know, exciting to talk about, because men actually connect their sexual confidence to their erectile functioning. And so a lot of times, you know, I have to help gents to say, you're still the man you were, whether your erection is working or not. You just have to build your confidence back up and understand that you are just fine. It just takes a while to get to the point of sitting back and saying, I'm afraid of this. I don't know what to do about this. How do I make this happen? How do I get this back to where I want it to be? Roderick, what's up? I'm so glad that you're here, and I appreciate that, love. But it's important. We never talk about this stuff because it's what? Taboo? But sex health is important, and we have relationship problems going on. I'm dealing, as a coach, I'm dealing with so many sexless relationships. It's ridiculous. And I'm like, okay, at this point, there's no Dr. Roos out here. I don't see any. And I'm not afraid to be put on the front line. Okay, if this is what I got to do to restore relationships, to get the bedrooms back to bedrock, then damn it, that's what I'm going to do. And I don't have the problem with going out here and studying and learning. What can we do to help men gain their self-confidence back, to get back towards their woman? Because see, understand this, sex health, sex engagement is a power. There is an energy that goes on when you are sexual. So outside of the actual act itself and the erectile health, yes, that's the beauty of it. But there's an unseen piece, which is the sexual energy. See, we hear all the time about power couples, right? I want to be like Bay and Jay, or I want to be like Obama and Michelle, or check out Will and Jada. I want to be like them. Okay, they're sexy. A lot. You can tell. Because why? There's a power between them, those two. And it cultivates a power in each of them individually that helps them to build the best version of themselves. This is why sexual energy is so important. And a lot of people want to, like I said before, a lot of people want to hide behind, the proud and prude trend. I'm proud and prude. I'm not having sex. Okay. That's your choice. Okay. But are you ever going to go back to sexual exploration or sexual? I mean, why? Because sex itself, the yin, the yang, the beauty of the two verse babies out here, you came from sex. What? That don't make sense. So I'm on a tangent. So anyway, let's get back to erectile functioning. So a lot of times, gentlemen, you are struggling with the confidence. But yet, like I said, there's so many pressures out here in society that connects your sexual performance and your size and all of those things into your mind to where it can actually hinder you from rising and performing, unfortunately. And so, you know, for me, I just want to give you guys different alternatives. So like I said, the rise and fall technique, I'm telling you what, powerful. It works. I'm telling you, the gentleman that I was coaching, is it, like I said, he's from India, inboxed me. Like, I'm having a hard time here. What do I need to do? And I told him, like, look, it's no worries, baby boy. It's something you just have to be patient with. Give yourself time. If something hasn't worked for a while, you have to be patient. You can't be on demand like you are with the cable. You have to allow your body to rejuvenate. Men have to have, like I said, men have to have time of recoup. You have to have time of rest. Gentlemen, if you are working 3 and 4 jobs, you are stressed, your relationship isn't so hot, you and your relationship are toxic, or you guys can't get along, all of these things can factor in your actual sexual performance. And so, be it as it may, this is very important that you allow yourself time to sit back and say, okay, let me try to improve on my own. And you can do this. Like I said, if you don't have a lady and you're just noticing that your erectile health isn't where you like it to be, or it isn't, you're not rising as often, that's fine. But what you need to do is you need to allow yourself to self-please and give yourself time to restore and understand the rise and fall technique really does improve. But you also have to understand that what's vital is that you don't put so much pressure on yourself, believing that I'm just not going to rise right now. And you would be amazed at how much mind over matter matters. It's crazy, I know. But if you stop causing yourself worry about how am I going to perform for my lady, but rather become selfless and lose yourself completely, you will find that it will allow your lady to then be concerned about how you're going to rise. Take all the pressure off yourself. A lot of the times it's you. It's not nothing wrong with you mentally. It's not. You're not having enough rest. You're not drinking enough water. You're eating horribly. You're not doing things to help your circulatory system to work properly. And so the sexual organ can only perform to what you put inside your body. With that said, there's some herbs that I have called Libido Man, and I have gentlemen already using them. Trust me, they're already using them. And some for themselves only. They don't have a partner. And other ones are using my herbs that have a partner. And they're coming back and they're telling me how great it is. And it's wonderful. I'm happy. I'm excited for them because they're getting their shoulders back. They're no longer feeling hunched over. They're no longer feeling like, oh my God, I'm not a man anymore. They're gaining back to the old them. Some of them inbox me like, man, I feel like a new man. You know, hey, I'm telling my boys about this. I'm like, awesome. It's called libido man. And libido man, on top of the rise and fall technique, is working very well for at least four of my clients right now. And they're very happy with it. So I want to share with you guys that libido man is something you can get from me. So you can either call me at 844-5-WISDOM. Or you can inbox me. You know, most of you guys know, you know, I'm an inbox away. So you can inbox me personally and I can give you all the details about what it is. But it's like a collection of herbs that helps to rejuvenate your penile health. And in the midst of that, one of my clients said, well, I'm going back to working out and eating better. And so he's working with the herbs. So that's even helping him even better. So I'm like, okay now, you know, so there's ways to restore penile health. It just takes a while to be willing to do the work. And like I told you, I am going to be talking about another technique that I will be talking about next month. It's going to be my version of the prostate massage. And, you know, for me, I just listen to men, you know, and I listen to how gentlemen respond when I talk about, hey, I've been studying about prostate massage. And I just get men, brothers, their face go white on me, like, and I'm like, well, what's all that about? They're like, oh, ain't nobody putting nothing up my behind, and I don't want nobody up there. And it's like, well, I'm working on it, brothers. I'm working on it. I'm trying to come up with a way to still help you with the reaching your G spot without having to do any type of invasive technique. So give me a minute. I know you guys don't want to, you know, deal with all that. So anyway, I'm studying the prostate massage, but I'm studying it to come up with a technique. And I think I got one almost mastered to where the man can have a unbelievable experience and really truly empty his prostate during intimacy. And in doing that, he can also fulfill his orgasmic experience. So now it's a mission for me to learn, well, you know, a lot of gentlemen are not okay with this prostate massage. So what can I do to improve a man's prostate enjoyment without invading his privacy? Absolutely, John. Without invading his privacy, but allowing him to still have the maximized enjoyment he deserves. So what can we do to do that? So I pretty much mastered it, but I want as many ladies that are on here, it's surprising because most of the time it's mostly all gentlemen. But ladies, if you're on here, you need to come to my next Sensually Speaking video chat because I'm going to be talking about the technique that helps, okay, to actually empty the prostate as best as you can. And in emptying the prostate, it actually promotes better prostate health. And the reason why so many people are getting the prostate massage is because it is under the guise of emptying the prostate actually helps to improve prostate health and can be an agent against prostate cancer. So with that said, I'm like, well, can a woman do that herself? I mean, do you have to have all of this massaging going on, or can a woman do this for her man? Can she, is she able and capable of doing the massage sexually to her man, to her partner, to her spouse, to who she's in engagement with? Can she do that? Or is this only done by, you know, this prostate massage? So I want to challenge that, because for me, I'm always like, you know, I am about health, yes, but I'm also about understanding that most gentlemen that come to me about their sexual concerns, sexual health, or sexual questions, they don't want the invasion. They don't. They're like, hey, I'm a man. I don't want, you know, all of that. So I'm like, okay, so does it take all of that? Because for me, I want to see how we can empty that prostate as much as we can during sexual intercourse. As much as we can. Because to me, the emptying of his prostate is promoting his health, his prostate health. Period. And if we can promote better prostate health, then this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to figure out a way that we can do this in an intimate setting, in a beautiful light, but yet without having the invasion. You know what I'm saying? Because listen, that's like having us ladies go into the bedroom with our men and he has stirrups up for us and those cold things to go inside of us and say, hey, we're going to have sex tonight, but we're doing it this way. That's what it reminds me of. And that makes me uncomfortable. I wouldn't want to do that. I wouldn't want to have that kind of experience intimately, you know? So I'm understanding I wouldn't want the stirrups in the bedroom. So I'm looking at it from a woman's perspective, like, well, I wouldn't want that. And I'm sure the gentleman don't want the prostate exam in his bedroom going on. He don't want that. So what can I do to make sure that he gets the same result without using that technique? So, and like I said, you guys have to join me. I do essentially speaking video chats once a month. And John's on there, Shadrick. I mean, all my guys, Brad. I mean, my guys come and we have a good time. We flow. We talk about intimacy. We talk about intimate, issues, concerns, things we need to know about. And to me, I think it's very important to restore relationships. We got to get back to how to restore the intimate life as well. Period. Point blank. If we're not going to restore the sexual understanding, then we're going to have a lot of gentlemen embarrassed or very concerned about how do I improve here? How do I get to a time where I can feel confident again? So I just wanted to come on here this evening and tell you, you can restore your sexual erectile functioning. It's not hard. It just takes patience. But it also takes time to acknowledge we have to. And if you need a wisdom coach to help you, to guide you through this, look me up. Inbox me. I'm just an inbox away, or call me 844-5-WISDOM. And I can help you to help point you to whatever it is that's hindering you from having the fulfillment. And a lot of times, like I said, it could be just in between the ears. It could just mean, you know, you're having some imbalances, so you need the the libido man, or it could be that you need to try some different techniques, or you just need to learn meditation. It's all kinds of things that can help you to restore your erectile functioning. It just takes time to really, get back to you. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of gentlemen that just aren't comfortable with talking about this, but it's important. I mean, because how are we going to fix it if we don't talk about it? You know? And so I feel it's important that we get this out, that we talk about it, that we really truly focus on how we can improve it. And in our improving the sexual functions, it will improve relationships, period. Just that simple. So again, like I said, if you have not joined me, please, by all means, let me know if you want to become a wisdom focus group member. It's $9 a month. You can do that as well. And by being a wisdom focus group member, you get my wisdom services a lot less expensive because you're a focus group member. So you get extra perks. And so, like I said, it's $9 a month to be a member on that. And so, you know, also, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, I have a lot of stuff over there where I discuss and talk about sexual health, sexual issues, how to improve, all kinds of stuff. Go over there and subscribe right now. I mean, don't miss out. It's so much you can learn from over there. So do that as well. But I wanted to come on here and just give you guys something that, you know, can help you to kind of breathe a fresh breath of air. And like I said, if you need a coach, don't hesitate to call me, because I understand that, you know, this is not the easiest conversation to have, even with a physician. Even sometimes with your partner, because you may feel like they'll feel some type of way or something. So, you know, if you need to talk about it, please, by all means, contact me 844-5-WISDOM-0. Okay. So I'm out of here, everybody. Make sure to share this video. I'm telling you right now, there is somebody out here struggling with this very issue. Erectile dysfunction is not easy, nor is it, I mean, it's just not easy to talk about, nor is it a easy, you know, situation you're going through as a relationship or even just physically. It's very trying. You know, a lot of years ago, I used to work in durable medical equipment, and gentlemen would come in and they would have a hood on their head, or they would come way up close to my face and tell me they needed a pump. And I'd be like, oh, you need a vacuum? No, yeah, I need a vacuum. Can you get that for me? And then I have to pull them in the back and show them how to use it. And so it's very shameful for a lot of gentlemen, because, you know, there's not a lot out here to really help a man to have his rise and be able to sustain a really, really a lot of days worth of sexual enjoyment, because a lot of those different techniques or even medications are actually on a supply limit. So you might at the max get 5 pills a month, maybe. Sometimes you get as little as 3. You're talking about some of these relationships are long-term relationships or marriages or lifelong partners, and they can't have sex but 3 times a week, and then they got to plan it out. It's like, ooh. And then you give them these vacuums and pumps, and I'm having gentlemen tell me, these aren't working for me. It's not working. I'm like, okay. Well, let's try something else. So I tell them about libido, man, and they're like, oh, my God. I get inboxes on a random. I'll be at work or driving down the road, and all of a sudden I get inbox. Hey, was this supposed to do all this for me? Like, yeah, it was. I feel like a new man now. I'm like, well, good. Then it's working. You know what I'm saying? So, and, you know, ladies, if you're on here and you are dealing with this issue with your mate, don't feel embarrassed either. Reach out to me. You know, I've heard at this point, I've heard it all, so nothing that's going to be embarrassing for me. So I can actually, like I said, help you with some things that I'm working on, you know, giving you some definite techniques and, you know, words of wisdom that you can use to help to even really inspire your mate. Because sometimes they just need to feel like a man, because some men feel, you know, emasculated when they're not able to perform sexually. They feel like, man, I don't even feel like a man now. It's like, but you are. Yeah, but I mean, you know, I'm not feeling it. So, you know, we really need to get these men back to their confidence. But in order to do that, they need to restore their erectile functioning so that they can get back to their confidence, because it definitely goes hand to hand. So I'm just saying. So I'm out of here, guys. I hope I helped someone this evening. Be sure to share this. If you guys need anything, don't hesitate. I am here. All right. I'm out of here, everybody. I'm Carla Nicole. I'm signing off. Best cat. Have a good night. Bye, guys.